There's the button that makes it start. Okay, this is list of, this is list of the confirmations here. We're inside the church now. And you can see a lot of familiar looking names. And the one I found here, where was it? I think it was in 86 or 87. Now there's a Went. There's Wilhelm Went in 1886. Let me check where. Yeah. Now my Will Went, my great-grandfather, was born in 1872. So I guess for 1886, that'd be him, wouldn't it? 14 years old. Is this like a baptism list, I guess, for the... Yeah, it sure is. Yeah, confirmation. So for him to be 14 years old, that'd be him, wouldn't it? Because he was born 14 years before this. How about that? There's my great-grandfather right there. Still listed as Wilhelm, not Well, but that's really wild. And then 1887, Lutheran. Some of the names on there. There's Matilda. There's Matilda Schlosser.
What's today, about 4th?
I don't know. Today is the 4th. It's October the 4th. Okay. It's my brother's birthday. Happy birthday, Roger. Since I guess he'll be watching this at some point, probably. Schmidt, Yonke. There's Herman Went. There's Lizzie.
They definitely
there's Lizzie.
In the church.
Yeah, there's my great-grandmother, Eliza Schlosser. And that would be 1890 with Herman Went. So that's funny. I mean, here she is, a 14-year-old kid in a class with the younger brother of the guy she would end up marrying those years later. Born 1876 was she, so this would be when she was 14 years old. Isn't that terrific?
It's a pretty good jaunt from the homestead over to here.
This is a ways?
Maybe 8, 9, 10 miles. Over.
Wow, so they traveled. Now there's John Frederick Went, 1893, who was a brother of Will. Dick is her in-laws. There were Dickas that married Wentz back in the old country. I don't think that would be a relation. I just recognize the name. There was a very prominent military leader named Dicka back in Germany that was a close relative of the Dicka that married one of the Wentz.
I did spend several hours here looking at the oldest book.
Yeah?
They were very nice to let me do that, and it's all written in German.
But the names look the same. That's like with the book I've got from Dirk from Gross and Canet, and it's in German, so I can read very, very little of it. But
this is how God works in mysterious ways. I just spent 2 years working on the transcription of the church in Grand Island before I came here. So I was able to sit down with that book and read the German.
So you knew enough of the words that you would encounter in something like that.
In 2 years, I learned a lot.
I bet.
Before I came here.
There's more hankies. Grotolution. Plug. Well, you can sure see a lot about this community. That's on. Now, this is the... We have a wall exactly like this at First Christian in Columbia, which our current pastor likes to refer to as the Dead Preacher Wall. Here's the Dead Preacher Wall. And this is Gustav Müller, who would have been around at the time our folks were here. I'm going to try to get a better copy of the picture. No, I'm just... Oh, you know what? It may be. I started to say it was from the window, but it's not. It is from the electric light. Yeah, that is better. That's Gustav Müller, who would have been here 1891 to 1900 and 1909 to 1918. And this is Christoph Messner, which is very interesting because I know Messner's in Columbia, including one that's a Lutheran minister. I'll have to be sure to show this to them. 1881 to 1891. And then this one also. Gronhorst, who would have been in between. Ludwig Gronhorst is 1900 to 1909. So these would have been the ministers for the family at the time.
I don't know where they are.
Okay.
There's another book I want to look at yet. But
this is the sanctuary.
For the altar?
Yeah.
Done in very modern style.
And not.
And the kindergarten kids came in and said, "Why is he so bad?"
Oh, that's a shame. These cords are to wind the clock. We've got the old clock here. And please wind the clock each Sunday, says the sign. I love this banner in the sanctuary. The welcome place.